Hey, Rick. Jersey City, make it fast. We got a show to do.
Opie, you're like two different people from the XM show and the Free FM show. Oh, my God, it's so much more fun at XM. That guy you're with, too, is funny. The guy who's
Bobby.
With Jimmy.
Bobby Kelly.
Not you.
All right, Rick.
Not
I
you.
Still get those messenger.
Thank you, Rick. Bastards.
No,
right?
we had to, like, clear the air the first half of the show today.
Yeah.
And then the old days, they would have wrecked the whole show the entire day, but we moved on.
See, finally. it's like going to work,
yeah.
And you have a problem at work, so you kind of vent, and then you come over, work is done, and you come over to a birthday party.
Yeah.
Which is what we have over here at XM. Every day is a birthday party.
Thanks for the birthday cake.
Heads full of candy and cake. And all kinds of fun.
Party balloons.
We drink smoothies and have fun.
Listen to music.
Oh, we disco dance.
Swoogie
music.
All right, Bob.
Yo.
You're on to something. I asked Bob during the break. Convertible Boy? I thought he had more to the song, but he doesn't.
No.
Can we play what he gave us?
We're still working on
it. Still working on isolating it? Bob, I got an idea. We like audience participation.
Yes.
We're going to give them the first part of the song, Convertible Boy.
Yes.
We want them to use you in the first part of the song, and then we want the listeners to finish the song.
That's a great idea.
They can make it into a country song. You could add music under Bob's part, and then you jump in. You could shred. You could
give them a lot of credit.
You could do whatever. You could go power ballad. I don't care. Whatever you want to do. And finish the song, Convertible Boy, because I think you're onto something. I think you got a hit there, Bob.
I think we can. I think I think the song is a sexy song.
Sexy.
Very visual.
How about you close your eyes and you do the song again, what you have of it? Okay. Hold on. We don't want anyone else talking because we want people to grab this and have fun with this.
Now, I want you guys to visualize, you know, a skinny guy with a Miami Vice type of outfit on, you know, pastel shirt and a sports jacket and maybe slip-on shoes with beautiful hair parted to the side with a little curl coming down in front
what
of his face.
What about a hoodie with safety pins on it?
No, that's too sexy. That's too sexy.
Ah, I'm too sexy for my sweatshirt.
And jumping in.
It hurts. Right, sir?
No.
No.
Gets so angry.
Can't say no right because he's so much candy in his head. All right, ready? Now, right. You have to picture Convertible Boy going to a crime. Beginning of the show. Ready? Hair blowing in the wind.
Okay. Convertible Boy. Boy, he's so amazing. Convertible Boy, he's so cute.
That's all you got?
That's it.
Can you give us more before?
No.
That was it.
That's all he said.
That's the hook. What'd you make up more lyrics in your head?
Convertible Boy.
Hope he kept going.
What have we learned from the show?
You brought it up.
He's amazing and he's cute. That's all we got.
Yeah, but he's a convertible boy.
And he's a convertible boy.
He's not a man, he's a boy.
Is he driving during this? Because I picture him driving, elbows kind of out the window, but, you know, it's convertible, so, you know, he's just kind of hanging out.
Yeah.
And he's kind of big, gleaming smile.
Perfect teeth.
Hair flowing.
Oh, beautiful.
And he's just got his dick buried in another man's asshole.
Well, not until he gets to the scene.
Oh, okay, sorry.
You never know. I mean, he's Convertible Boy.
I picture more of an innocent song.
Very innocent.
Very innocent.
But sexy. You want to get that?
I like your Marilyn Monroe delivery, you faggot.
All right. Well, Bob is done.
Happy birthday to Convertible Boy.
Oh, you can really go in a different direction, can't you?
Yeah,
at the drop of a dime, you can go.
Hold on. I'm going to show you the brilliance of the listeners, though. Yeah. So they take that. That part has to be in the song, and then they finish the Convertible Boy song. Maybe we'll get a fine prize in the end. I don't know. You can throw a good part, of course. We're going to put it up on opieandanthony.com. All right. But give the people out there some oohs and ahs, and too, that maybe they could put into the song as well.
Oh, okay. Shh.
Right. I have to get into character to do this because I have to become Convertible Boy.
Yeah, pinch your nipples.
Sam, can you sit on my lap, please?
No,
come here. Seriously, I need your help.
Like, no,
just come here. Sit
just
on my
do
lap.
It, Sam. It's not good.
Sit on my lap.
You're doing it for the radio show.
Are you wearing a bag?
Come here, sit on my lap.
Make sure you put on a bag.
Come here, sit right here.
My mommy wouldn't approve of this.
Sit. You see that thing that feels like a roll of quarters? Sit on it.
Oh my God, Jesus!
Come here, just get over here.
Holy crap!
You are the creepy uncle.
Come here.
Okay.
Well, that is the creepiest picture.
You know what the best part about this is? My knee was cold. Now it's not because his groin is warm.
Groined?
It's like hot.
His groined?
Let's
Bob, you add a D to that.
All right, everyone be quiet. Bob, give him some... Bob, give him some oohs and ahs so they can add it to the song.
Oh. Oh. Ooh. Mmm. Convertible boy. Oh. Stay still, you fucking faggot. Oh. Yeah. Wowee. Convertible boy. Hmm, baby.
All right, very good. Now,
Sam.
Now, we got some experts out there. If you experts need anything else for Bob to do for your convertible boy song, give us a call, and we'll let Bob do that for you.
That made me feel weird.
Oh,
look at Sam sweating.
Sam's sweating.
Why are you sweating?
No, it's just sugar coming out.
He wiped his brow. Look at him.
I'm not sweating.
Oh, my God. He sweats maple syrup.
No.
Yeah, you do. I see it.
The picture of him on my lap with his head bowed like I'm forcing him.
Yeah. All right. The Convertible Boy Song Contest has begun. Have fun. Have fun. We hope hopefully we'll get a couple for Monday's show.
Maybe one of those dudes can draw a picture, too, of Convertible Boy.
All right. You want to listen to some Convertible Boy remixes?
That I do.
Not really.
All right, well, Robert Kelly was in for Jim Norton on Friday. He did a good job, and we got into, like, gay songs and stuff. I don't even know how. There's a song on, whatever. We can't play it over here, so whatever. I guess Robert said he has a gay song.
Yeah, Bobby came up with a gay song like that. He sings, but that he was writing, but he only wrote, like, two lines to it. And he sang it for us. And we thought the audience could pick up the ball and maybe add some music to it, redo some of the clips over again so it's longer than just two lines, do a little remix.
I hope this is a bit that Preston and Steve would do so we'd be in the same company as a great morning radio show like theirs.
Look, all I want to do is look good in John Minnelli's eyes.
That's right.
And he seems to like their show.
Would Preston and Steve do a bit like this? Boy, I hope so. Boy, I hope so.
Gosh, golly, gee, just like us, John.
Boy, I hope they would do something like this. I haven't forgotten.
Give him an auto in, George.
Ugh. The weekend did nothing to calm me down. Anyway, here's the clip from Robert Kelly on Friday.
I wrote a gay song, by the way, too.
You did?
I did. I wrote it. You want to hear it?
Yeah.
It's called Convertible Boy.
Oh.
I wrote it. It's for a cartoon. He's a superhero. And he drives a convertible, and he's like a white, upscale dude.
No, yeah.
And it starts out like this. Convertible boy. He's so amazing. Convertible boy. He's so cute.
That's really gay, Bob. That's really
so creepy.
That's really gay.
I wrote that.
I just picture you singing that over some young boy's body.
Well, that's the beginning of the thing. He jumps in and he's looking in the rear view and he's so cute. I got it.
So that's the clip from Friday. And
he's got so many issues.
Oh, he's got way more issues than little Jimmy Norton.
Just to come up with something like that. Yeah. Like,
and then we got excited. We're like, all right, let's hear more of the song. It's like, that's all I've written.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what? So we put the pieces up on the website, and now the listeners are trying to make a song out of what Robert Kelly sang on Friday. And we said you could add to it. You could add to it lyrically as well as musically.
Yeah.
So they're coming in. You want to hear a couple of these real fast?
Sure.
I don't know where we should go with this bit, if we should continue down this road where we get Convertible Boy songs, or maybe as a show we try to make the gayest song ever made.
The gayest song ever made.
That could be a goal of our show.
Well, they for how gay that was, him just doing it a cappella.
Yeah.
When people added in music, it really took on a whole new gay life.
But I'm thinking we do work parts. We all do, like, I don't know, moaning and whatever it would take. Throw it on a website and see if the listeners could come up with the gayest song ever. Is that a good bit? Oh, I hope so. Oh, boy, do I hope so. What do you got over there?
Nothing. I'm just looking for the gayest song ever.
How are you looking for it?
Well, might actually have it.
What?
Yeah, we might.
That's just that's pretty much music.
And of course, playing the xylophone on Robert Reed's ribs.
Greg and Bobby, get in here. Oh no. Prostate cancer exams again.
Bobby, it's your turn. Let me just snap this rubber glove on. Ah, screw the rubber glove. Who needs it? Didn't use one on this. Why use it on my hand?
Who knew back then?
Poor Robert Reed.
Can't blame the guy. He didn't know.
Went from the Brady Bunch to playing a tranny in a TV movie. Yeah, well, he really wanted to tell people, hello, I'm not the guy you watched for three or four years.
Hey, so why don't we play a Convertible Boy remix? They took the raw audio of Bob Kelly there.
Here's the, well, actually, we do have some audio of Robert Reed when he was having sex with that wrong person. See, it's that Tiki wasn't around giving him the AIDS.
See, in case you don't know, Robert Reed died of AIDS.
Well, he was the father on the Brady Bunch, which was a television show.
Over-explain it.
Well, that was a television show, late 60s, early 70s, very popular, still showing reruns today.
Yeah.
See, because you got to explain why a guy's being spanked by another guy.
And that's Davis, what we're getting at. Alice, too.
Because now we have to explain why we're over-explaining.
Okay, I got the gayest song ever. Oh, song. I thought you meant singer.
All right, here we go.
Singer.
This is Lunchbox Eric. He took Bob Kelly's audio and he came up with this.
Bobby's gay. Bobby's gay.
You think?
Just face it. He's trying to deal with it, but when he was talking about Sam on Friday, that wasn't fake. He was really talking about how he would, you know, have sex with Sam.
It's okay, because he was in foster homes.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, and he's trying not to be, you know? He's like with the girlfriend and everything, and it's just not working, though. When he comes out with a Convertible Boy song out of nowhere and can really sell it.
He sold it all.
He put it over completely with his delivery. And that horrible piano music you only hear in cancer treatment commercials. Oh, God. But now that's one type of gayness, you know, the very mellow. Mm-hmm. Who would think the same words by the same person could be brought upbeat into a gay dance tune? But someone actually did that.
Well, we got, I think, I don't know if this is that. We got John F. Let's listen to this one.
John F.
Took Bob Kelly's Convertible Boy, just the little that Bob, you know, gave us. He's holding the rest inside for whatever reason.
Leave him wanting more.
And we really wanted more vocals from Bob Kelly, but John F. took what Bob gave us, and he came up with this version.
Mm-hmm.
Boom,
Yeah, this is gayness.
She's so amazing. Convertible boy.
See?
Yeah.
This is just...
What visual are you getting right now?
Oh, just amyl nitrate poppers, pillow biting, and the smell of musky, musty...
Musk.
Ugh. Things just being places they shouldn't be.
Like men kissing each other, but holding the back of each other's heads and roughly kissing each other.
Yeah, where did this music come from? Wow.
See, this bit has potential. It needs just a little more. Maybe a little more vocals from Bob Kelly so the listeners could really have fun. The work pieces are up on opiananthony.com so you can make your own remix.
This is music that after you hear it, even the next day when you're eating a sandwich and you bring it up to your mouth, your fingers still, they don't smell like the sandwich.
Especially if it's tuna.
It smells nothing like that.
Not a fan of sushi, are you?
Nine.
And then we got Septic Tank.
Septic Tank?
Well, Septic Tank,
the art of Septic Tank.
We told the fine folks out there that they could add vocals to Bob Kelly's vocal.
Yeah.
So this is the first one that is actually trying to write more lyrics to the masterpiece that is Convertible Boy.
It's pretty bad, I think.
This is the beginning of a bit I think that's going to work very well in the coming weeks. You're seeing the beginnings here. So here's Septic Tank.
Convertible Boy, he's so amazing.
I gotta be honest. We played this during the break a couple times, and I wanted to strangle this guy.
Yeah.
But now I like the song.
I don't like it.
Yeah.
He's almost got a James Gum delivery.
Yeah.
Convertible Boy.
Convertible Boy.
You better size 14. Convertible Boy.
Would you?
He's so amazing.
Would you?
Convertible Boy. He's so cute.
Would you?
One day, I was walking down the road.
Guy.
Hey, that was like a slow idea. Hey, come
on. He didn't write anything.
Convertible Boy. He's so cute.
You gotta love the hook, though.
No, I can't take
boy,
this guy.
He's so amazing.
He thinks he's being clever, and he's just sitting there making things up as he goes along.
I like it.
Stinks.
I like it. Maybe we should learn how to tune a guitar.
Yeah.
He didn't want his guitar tuned. He's going for the out-of-tune effect.
Yeah.
All right. Well, it goes on and on and on.
Yeah, and that's another thing.
On and on and on.
It just goes on and on.
Yeah, your Convertible Boy song's got to be less than 2 minutes, all right?
Shut it.
Let's keep it, because, you know, ADD. That's what America has these days. We don't have enough time to sit through this crap. All right. So there you go. There's potential there with Convertible Boy thing.
A little bit.
We don't know where it's going to end up. Maybe we get Bob Kelly to write some more lyrics. You know, but you could write a song with what Bob has given you. It's up on opiananthony.com.
He is supplied.
Career.